Fu Game Pro, martial artist, sharpshooter, game reviewer, director.
Hey guys, Fu Game Pro here. Sorry my throat's feeling really sore, so I'll try to speak up as much as possible. I know I said with my last video review on the Mountain House dry food rations or cooked dinners or whatever you might want to call it. I said I was going to try to do it outside, but this one is made for wraps, so and it's going to be messy to do, you know, of course, because you're going to have to be using, you know, some tortillas for it. So I'm just going to go ahead and do this at home. Maybe the next one will be out in the woods, hopefully. Anyway, let's go ahead and get on with it. This is the Mountain House Wraps Fillings. This is the chicken fajita filling. Strips of chicken with fire roasted onion. Red and green bell peppers with black beans. It's got 26 grams of protein per serving. It's got some nice pictures in the back of what it's supposed to look like. Let's take a look at that and we'll see if that's actually what it looks like when it's done. Let's see, serving size is 1 1/4 cups dry. And there's two servings per container, so this will feed my wife and I. There's 240 calories from fat, 2 grams of total fat. Of course, this is per serving. Saturated fat is 0, trans fat is 0, cholesterol is 55 grams, sodium is 630 milligrams, which is pretty high, but that's expected for a dried food. 260 milligrams of potassium, total carbohydrates is 26 grams, which is something you would like to have out in the wilderness. You need the energy. Dietary fiber is 8 grams, sugars 10 grams, and protein 26 grams. So, let's go ahead and start on this. This one's going to be, let's see, a seasoning pack. It's only going to take 12 ounces of water this time. And again, we're going to let it sit for 9 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and let it sit for 11 minutes this time, just to see if there's a better soaking in of the meats than the last one, and see how that works if you let it sit a little bit longer. Let's go ahead and get started in that. This time I actually will be using a measuring device, because it is 12 ounces instead of the 16 ounces. Like I said, next time I do one of these, I'll try to do it outside with some utensils that you would bring on a camping trip or situation where you're not from in home at the house. Again, we just go ahead and add the water and get it started boiling. Okay, once it's boiling, we'll go ahead and come back to it. Okay, the water is boiling now. I'm going to go ahead and turn this off. Something to think about is how much water are you losing when you boil the water. So I'm going to go ahead and put it back into the cup. So I lost about a half an ounce to an ounce just from that. So it might be something to think about. Let's go ahead and open this up. Take a look inside. Okay, we have the do not eat packet, of course. And now this one's also got a seasoning packet in it too. If I can get it out without destroying everything. Okay, so that's what it looks like. Go ahead and make sure your bottom, of course, is kind of flat. Then we're going to add the water. Mix it around again. And then we're going to have to let it sit. For 11 minutes. And we'll come back, add the seasoning, and try it out. Okay, so it's been 11 minutes. Let's go ahead and open this up. Now it says on the packaging to stir it well again and then drain the extra water. So I'm going to close it up just a little bit just so I have a little peephole and then drain some of the water out. There's actually quite a bit of water still left in there. I'm going to go ahead and open up the seasoning packet. Here's the seasoning, by the way. Let me mix that up. What it looks like inside. Let's dump it out and see what it looks like. Okay, let's go ahead and dump it out and see what we got. In case I didn't mention it before, it does have 26 grams of protein per serving. And that's what it looks like. Enough to probably make 2 fajitas each. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Trying to get some bean in there too. It's good. It tastes a little bit heavy on the seasoning. It's good. It's edible. I would say that the mac and chili tasted better. The meat feels very soggy. The chicken. It almost tastes like it's pre-chewed. It's very soggy. But, you know, it's freeze-dried. You know, what do you expect? So let's go ahead and get my wife's opinion on this. Okay, honey, go ahead and give it a try.
My sister's setting up for both of us or just one?
No, just go ahead and try some from the thing there. And give me your honest opinion.
It's actually kind of good. It's got like just a touch of spice and the chicken's not rubbery like the beef was in the last one.
I thought it was a little bit soggy.
It's not too bad. I mean, it's gonna get much greens, I guess.
We'll try another whole chunk. Let's try a whole new chunk, honey.
Well, I'm gonna try to get some vegetables. There you go. The vegetables are, they're not squish, but they're pretty tender. I mean, it's not like crisp peppers and stuff.
Okay.
I like it. I think it's good.
Well, it's passable, right?
It's passable.
It's good. Okay. We're going to go ahead and separate these and have them in the fajita. Of course, you could eat it like this. I thought there was a little bit too much seasoning into it. Maybe dine it down with the tortilla will make it better. Let's give that a shot. Okay, so let's go ahead and try this. See if I feel any different with it as a little burrito tortilla. Now, I do have a little cold, so my taste might be a little bit off, but the tortilla does die down some of the seasoning a bit, and my first bite could have been, I may have not mixed it very well, but that does taste better that way, and the tortilla gives it more of a chewy flavor, where you're not noticing how spongy the meat feels to me. Let's see what my wife thinks of it. Go ahead, Bendir. Better with the tortilla, or?
It takes a lot of the spice out of it, which I liked the spice before. Like, maybe I got a better mixed section.
Mm-hmm.
But before, you can actually taste a little zip to it.
Okay. So for you, it was better to taste it out of the bowl and eat it out of the bowl than it was with the tortilla?
A little. Like, okay. I didn't get as much spice.
Well, there's two different opinions for you. Next time, I'll try to get two different opinions as well. Hope that helps you out, though, with this. It's definitely edible. It's good. Everybody's going to have their own opinions, of course, though. And as I said before, it is a freeze-dried food, so you can't expect, gourmet out of it. Hope you like this video, and I will continue tomorrow and say if it was feeling enough for the rest of the night, which is important. If I do get hungry throughout the night, I'll come back and make a video saying that I did get hungry. You guys, till then. Okay guys, this is actually only 3 hours after eating the meal. 2.5-3 hours. Yeah, actually I think, yeah. Maybe just a little over 3 hours. My wife and I are both starting to feel hungry. I was actually surprised after having the chili macaroni dinner, which had the same serving sizes on it, how that filled me up past 6 hours into the next day, I wasn't hungry. But this one, you know, just a little past 3 hours, and both her and I are starting to feel hungry. So I don't know why that is. I don't know if it's empty calories. It's really a surprise because it's vegetables and chicken, which should have lasted longer than the other. I'm not a nutritionist, so I don't understand why that compared to the carbohydrate, more carbohydrate type of meal with the macaroni as a filler, why it was like that. But anyway, I just wanted to give you my 2 cents worth on that. I would probably pass on this one. I don't know, maybe if you ate the whole bag by yourself. But we both don't have a lot of energy right now either. I mean, the other one we felt just fine, and now we're, you know, we're hungry and we're feeling like there's we just don't have a lot of energy. But you know, I would first think this because my throat's starting to hurt, and maybe it might be coming down with something, but you know, she's feeling the same way. So yeah, like I said, my 2 cents, take it as you will. I would probably just pass on this one. Especially if you have to have tortillas to make it a proper meal. You want to try to keep the less amount as possible where tortillas don't last forever. Like these, the date, by the way, on this one was 2018. I don't know when it was made, but it makes me wonder if this one was made the same time as the other one. If they don't last as long, but it could have been that this one was sitting on the shelf for a year, where the other one wasn't. Anyhow, take it as you will. You guys all have a good day.